Good evening. Sydney has been hit by a wall of rain tonight, with a powerful storm sweeping from our west to our east, downing trees and damaging properties. As we go to air, trains aren't running from Glenfield to Liverpool, and it's a nightmare for commuters.
A show in the sky, clouds gliding over Wollongong, the spectacular formation seen from the Parramatta River at Meadowbank to the beach near Warilla.
You're inside very soon.
The eerie darkness, a sign of what was to come.
It's dropped about 10 degrees. I've got to go and put a jacket on.
An early knockoff for this yard at Nowra, forced to wait it out. No matter where you were, it was impossible to escape. Thunder rattling the Blue Mountains, a deluge across the state. At Lithgow, flooded roads, streets covered in knee-high water. Hail hammering this Bilpin home, turning the front yard white. Then it was the city's turn. As day turned to evening, our harbour lost its sparkle, right on time for the busy commute home. A lightning strike splitting overhead train wires, closing the T2 line between Glenfield and Liverpool, needing urgent repairs. Wild winds at Narrabeen. Motorists urged to take caution or even stay inside. Easier said than done. In the city, James Wilson, Nine News.
Let's go straight to Madison Scott at Birchgrove. Maddie, it's going to be a busy night for SES crews.
Yeah, Pete, the storm rolled in hard and fast right across Sydney this afternoon, causing destruction. I'll take you right to this tree here that's fallen behind us in Birchgrove. You can't see, but behind that foliage is actually a cracked windscreen, and the tree has blown out the passenger windows. This tree is connected to a live wire, and we've got fire and rescue crews on scene with police here now. There has been an exclusion zone put in place, and residents have been told to stay away. Now, the SES have responded to 120 calls for help this afternoon, and we have also seen destruction in Sydney's southwest, and that storm has now moved up to the Hunter. Pete?
It was a warm, sunny and humid day before storms rolled across this afternoon, bringing heavy rain and moderate to gusty winds. It reached 29 degrees in Penrith, Blacktown and Liverpool, 30 the top in Campbelltown. The coast a little cooler, 26 in Terre Hills, 25 in the city and 28 in Cronulla. We've seen a widespread 5 to 20 millimetres of rain today. The heaviest falls were in our southwestern suburbs around Bankstown and Peakhurst. Those showers and storms spread right across central and eastern New South Wales, bringing 10 to 20 millimetres of rain. The heaviest falls were centred around the central west. Temperatures ranging from 21 in Wollongong up to 26 in Wagga Wagga and Bathurst, a warmer 30 in Griffith and Dubbo. Tomorrow, troughs and lows will trigger more showers and storms over New South Wales and Queensland. Brisbane will be fine, 27 degrees, heading for a partly cloudy 28 in Canberra, 31 in Melbourne, a scorching 40 degrees for Adelaide under blue skies, a milder 24 on the way for Perth. Light showers are expected across the New South Wales coast tomorrow, bringing another 1 to 10 millimetres. We are expecting heavier falls around the northern tablelands with between 10 to 20 millimetres. Heading for tops of 27 in Grafton, Newcastle and Batemans Bay, 31 in Albury, Dubbo and Narrabri, and very warm in the west, 40 for Broken Hill. There is a coastal wind warning from the Macquarie coast all the way down to Eden. After more showers tonight, Sydney will be partly cloudy tomorrow. There is a 30% chance of showers in the city and a 60% chance in our west with light to moderate northeasterlies. If that rain arrives, we're expecting just 1 or 2 millimetres along the coast, but up to 6 millimetres of rain across inland suburbs. Heading for tops of 28 to 30 degrees across our western suburbs, including Penrith and Campbelltown, 26 for Terre Hills, 27 in Gosford and the city, 24 for Cronulla. Let's take a look ahead, and Saturday is looking absolutely beautiful, sunny and 29 degrees, a partly cloudy 26 on Sunday, cool and cloudy next Monday, 24, before the sun returns briefly on Tuesday with showers again midweek. Nights warmer than average, ranging from 16 to 18 degrees. In our west, a hot day on Saturday, soaring to 36 degrees, hot and mainly fine on Sunday with a possible late shower. Cloudy and 26 on Monday, mostly sunny on Tuesday, 32 degrees, before showers on Wednesday. Those nights also warmer than average, 15 to 19 degrees, Pete.
Hello again. It's been a rather low-key Thursday as the city climbed to a mild top of 23. Got a little warmer through northern suburbs, Yarra Glen warmed up to 20. 26, Epping 25, Tullamarine and Scoresby 24. The northwest of the state reached the low 30s again, but it's been cooler across the south with maximums in the high teens and low 20s. There have been a few isolated storms across the eastern ranges, but there's only a very slight chance that they'll extend over the Dandenong ranges tonight. Tomorrow we'll be under warmer northerly winds, giving daytime temperatures a boost, but a front will switch winds to cooler southerlies again on Saturday, so Melbourne will reach its maximum quite early in the day and the cooler conditions will stay with us well into next week. Tomorrow, Adelaide will be the country's hottest capital with a real scorcher, 40 degrees, 24 in Perth. Hobart has a beautiful sunny Friday on the way with a top of 27. Canberra is heading for 28, Sydney 27 and Brisbane 26. Back home, it'll be another mild night with most locations staying in double figures. Southern districts will warm up into the high 20s and low 30s and northern districts are forecast to climb into the 30s. 37 at Horsham and Swan Hill and Mildura is expected to hit 40 for the first time since March. That's quite early. Last year it didn't reach 40 until the 27th of December. And Saturday will be a day of extreme fire danger for the Mallee. Most of Melbourne is expected to dip to 12 or 13 degrees overnight and there'll be some patchy fog about during the morning, but once the sun breaks through, temperatures will get moving very quickly with maximums of 33 forecast for Melton and Epping, 32 at Laverton and Ringwood, 30 and 31 for most other suburbs, 27 at Rosebud and just like today, winds will be light. After an overnight low of 12, Geelong is heading for 31 degrees, a low of 13 for the city, then it's also set to reach 31. Then a very warm and rather windy night into Saturday. It's only expected to drop to 20 degrees before reaching 25 under partly cloudy skies. The winds will continue to be gusty during the morning and a southerly change should arrive before midday, so it'll be a cooler afternoon. After that, we are in for a run of days in the high teens, 18 on Sunday, 19 Monday, 17 Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. But we've got a hot one on the way tomorrow. A low of 13 and it'll be a little cloudy during the morning, but then we're expecting a top of 31 under beautiful sunny skies, Pete.
Well, some more nice days firstly, Andrew, but yes, we can look forward to some rain. We desperately need it, but not until this time next week. And I'm afraid temperatures will get very warm indeed early next week. We're looking at mid-30s for our inner suburbs, but across next Thursday, we should start to see some rain falling across southeast Queensland. Let's enjoy a few fine and mostly sunny days firstly. Let's have a look at temperatures recorded today across southeast Queensland. It was nice to see those temps return to the November average. Very comfortable across southeast Queensland today with light winds to start the day. Temps range from 26 on the Golden Sunshine Coast up to a maximum of 30 in Gatton and Ipswich. 29 in Bow Desert, 28 in Brisbane, Archerfield 29 along with Logan, 27 for Caboolture and 26 in Toowoomba. Now on the weather map, showers and storms will fire up across New South Wales, Victoria, outback Queensland and over the tropics. While heat building throughout the interior will push down into the southeast corner of the country and especially South Australia tomorrow. Have a look at the capitals and Adelaide, 40 degrees tomorrow. Starting to heat up in Melbourne with 31. Hobart and Sydney fine and 27. Showers and storms expected across Darwin at the top end. Queensland mostly fine and low 30s around Cairns, Townsville and Rocky. High 20s for Mackay and Gladstone. A mostly sunny one tomorrow across the Wide Bay and Burnett with 29 degrees in Gympie. Showers and thunderstorms though for Mount Isa, that's a definite. Now Longreach, 37 degrees with the chance of those late showers and storms. For the southeast, a partly cloudy day, the slight chance of an afternoon thunderstorm only around the southern border ranges. Definitely seeing some storms tomorrow around the Granite Belt and the Southern Downs, but they shouldn't reach the southeastern corner. Temperatures tomorrow, well, mid-20s on the coast and bayside, high 20s inland. Moreton Bay, the northeasters, 10 to 15 knots. They'll be light in the morning. The seas below 1 metre. So the best conditions out early tomorrow, boaties. Brisbane, partly cloudy skies. We're still looking at mid-20s tomorrow, but it's set to climb over the weekend. Have a look at your 7-day outlook. Sunday, 29 degrees. Monday and Tuesday, 30 degrees. Now Wednesday, expecting 32 before some rain on Thursday. Ipswich, fine and 29 Saturday, 32 Sunday, 34 Monday, 35 Tuesday and Wednesday. For the Goldie, partly cloudy weekend, up to 27 on Sunday, 29 Monday, Tuesday, and 30 degrees for Wednesday. The Sunshine Coast heating up over the weekend, 27 Sunday, 29 for Monday and Tuesday. Tuesday and peaking at 31 degrees on Wednesday. A taste of summer as we move into early next week, Andrew, but that rain will be welcome next Thursday.
Thanks, Cade. And as we soar towards 40 degrees tomorrow, that heat could be one for the record books. It hasn't been that hot this early in November since 1897. And thankfully, it wasn't that hot today. It's still warmer than expected with our top of around 31 degrees. Right now, it's around 28 degrees in the city. Across the suburbs, certainly plenty of spring warmth around our suburbs and temperatures around that 10, 11 degree mark overnight. We then reached 33 degrees this afternoon at Elizabeth, but it was cooler by the coast with Glenelg enjoying sea breezes and a milder 24. Many spots in our north have also been copping the heat that's headed our way. We had 42 degrees at Roxby Downs and also some outback rain and storms at Oodna Datta. A whole 20 degrees cooler through the southeast today, where Mount Gambier reached a milder 22 degrees. On the charts, one of the factors causing tomorrow's heat is a trough dragging hot air down from the centre of the country, and that trough could also trigger some more storms in our far north. Adelaide is set to be the hottest capital tomorrow, with conditions looking a little easier around the country. Sydney expecting a partly cloudy 27 and Brisbane 26. But have a look at the heat through South Australia. Pretty sweltering stuff. 43 degrees at Port Pirie, Port Augusta and up through to Woomera and Cooper Pedy too. Renmark also looking uncomfortable with 42. Murray Bridge 41 and Nuriutpa expecting 40. Along with that heat, we have windy weather and extreme fire danger ratings for the eastern and lower Eyre Peninsula. And take care by the water. We also have marine wind warnings in place for western and central regional coastlines. On metro waters, winds becoming southwesterly, 15 to 20 knots in the evening, then tending southerly with that change. So the Adelaide suburbs, both Elizabeth and Marion, expecting 40 degrees, a touch softer by the coast with Outer Harbour in for 38. The city is also expected to hit that 40 degree mark. But there is a late change arriving tomorrow, probably around 7, 8 o'clock. And so by the weekend, we're actually back down into the mid-20s. So certainly much more bearable. And next week also looking to be in that spring sweet spot.